Unit 2, The Beginning, How God Created the World. So in Module 2, we spent a whole module looking at a lot of the pieces and trying to put together the pieces that kind of go together that are all part of the beginning of the story of the Bible, right? We're starting to put some of the pieces together, and we looked at some of the pieces that happened before creation, some of them which we find in different parts of the Bible, some of them which we find in Genesis, but all of the pieces that kind of are at play as we look at the beginning of the story. And so in Module 3, we're going to take a deep dive into creation. And in this unit, we're going to look specifically at the beginning, looking at how God created the world. And of course, when we look at the beginning, we looked at this last time, right? And this is the very first verse of the book of Genesis. It's the very first verse of the Bible. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And if we go on from there, the second verse says that the earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the water. So these are the first two verses of the entire Bible and of the book of Genesis. And we look a lot about that first verse, right? In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. We kind of examined a lot of the things that go with that in the previous module on before creation. But the second verse is interesting because I don't know if you've ever wondered this, but this is an interesting phrase, right? This phrase, without form and void. What does this phrase mean? So I don't know if you've ever thought of that, but it's a common question. What does it mean that God created the world without form and void? Like, did he mess up, or I don't know what's going on? But it clearly says that it was without form and void in Genesis 1:2. Now, these two words in the Hebrew, these are actually the Hebrew words that we translate that phrase without form and void into. These are where they come from. And these are the two words in Hebrew, bohu and tohu. So we know that in Hebrew, we read from right to left. And so the meanings of these words are, well, tohu is formless, empty, chaos, right? That's what the word tohu means. And then the word bohu means void. So I'm no Hebrew scholar, but I have been told that the way that this is read in Hebrew is tohu vabohu, right? Without form and void, or formless and void. And now, interestingly enough, the word right before it is this one right here. And this is the Hebrew word haya, right? Not haya. No, that's a karate sound. But the word haya, and this word haya means to be translated to be, or was. So you can see how this creates the pieces that we translate into was, formless, and void, going from right to left, right? But some scholars have wondered if it means was, and some of them, there's been the suggestion that a better translation of the Hebrew word haya is not was, the earth was formless or void, but possibly was the word became. Now, this is a bit of conjecture, but follow me for a second, right? Because this might play into a little bit about what we had talked about last time in the previous module. So Genesis 1 says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep. But interestingly, if it was translated this way, the earth became without form and void, that could create some interesting discussion, right? Especially in light of some of the events that we know could very well have taken place before the creation, or as part of the creation story, right? The story we talked about with Lucifer and the angels, that could have all played a role in making the earth without form and void. I don't know. It's conjecture. It's not something I would hang my full theology on, but it's interesting, especially in light of some of the spiritual elements and some of the things that we know had to be in place by the time Genesis 3 rolls around and Lucifer, who is now Satan, is in the garden with Adam and Eve and is already against them. So a lot of stuff had happened before that we know. But whether it was or whether it was became, we know that it was without form and void. And so what does this phrase mean, right? Well, one of the things I think is interesting is that this phrase, I think, is a clue to the creation order. And what do I mean by the creation order? Well, the actual order of creation, right? The actual days. And so in the next unit, what I want to do is I want to look at the days of the creation of the earthly realm. So the actual creation process that God used to bring forth the earthly realm. So join me in the next unit.